Good morning, Tigers, and welcome back to the world's greatest elementary school. We hope that you all had a great winter break and a happy holiday season. Tigers, you helped brighten the holidays for so many of our families with gifts you brought in for the Maple Valley Food Bank's Toy and Gift Drive. Our Shadow Lake Caring community donated 624 toys and 50 gift cards. Way to go, Tigers!
Wow, we do have some amazing students here, Mr. Mitchell. Don't we?
Oh, man,
our Tigers are great. Hey, and Tigers, since we're just getting back from break, we thought it would be a great time to remind all of our Tigers about the Tiger way of showing respect, making good decisions, solving problems. In fact, over the next few days, your teachers are gonna be reviewing all of the ways that you can show the Tiger way around our school. In fact, you can pull out that passport book from the beginning of the year and review all of those ways that you can help make Shadow Lake the world's greatest elementary school.
Hey, and not only are we in a new year, but since we are in a new month, it's time to recognize our December Student of the Month. On Wednesday, all of our Tigers who are being recognized as Students of the Month for being quality producers are going to be invited to come down to the courtyard with their certificates, get your picture taken, and we'll put that up on the Student of the Month wall out in the hallway down to the lunchroom.
Yep.
So we're very excited about that, and we're gonna show them on Tiger TV also. So for the month of January though, here we are, it's January. We'll be focusing on the next trait of being an effective communicator. Students who show this trait communicate clearly and work to understand others.
Oh, so looking forward to seeing those Students of the Month on Wednesday and getting all those pictures up there. Hey, I have a special announcement for all of our fifth grade students. It's that time of the year again for our fifth graders to work to design a cover for this year's Shadow Lake yearbook. So fifth graders, pull out all your art supplies. Time to make a design for the yearbook cover. Our theme for this year is Every Tiger, Every Day, Be You. And we are looking forward to seeing all of those fantastic yearbook cover entries from our fifth graders.
All right, well, hey, we're not gonna be doing a Tiger ticket drawing on Tiger TV this morning, because we just did drawings at the assembly on Friday before break started. But we will be doing more drawings starting next week. So get those Tiger Paw tickets turned into your teachers so that we can have some awesome drawings. Okay, Mr. Abby, I missed story time the last few weeks because of break. So what's going on with story time this week?
Oh, I'm so excited that we are back with story time with Mrs. Smith, our amazing Shadow Lake librarian. I missed it too over break too.
Yeah.
I love the story time. All right, so today Mrs. Smith is reading a book called Stick and Stone.
Ooh, Stick and Stone, that's a good one.
I've read that one.
Yep. All right, Tigers, again, welcome back and Happy New Year. Lunch is gonna be a surprise because we just don't quite know yet, but you will know now that you're here today. So I hope you guys all have a great week. And at this time, turn your attention to your teacher for the Pledge of Allegiance. And remember,
it's a great day to be a Tiger.
Hey, Tigers, Happy New Year! Oh, welcome back to the world's greatest elementary. I hope you guys had a great couple weeks off, and I am super excited to read to you the first story for the new year. So today I'm going to read Stick and Stone. This is written by Beth Ferry and Tom Lichtenheld. Stick and Stone. This was an award-winning story couple years ago, several years ago, actually. But I think it has got such a good meaning. It's a very simple story, so pay very close attention. Stick. Stone. Lonely. Alone. A zero. A one. Alone is no fun. Stick, stone, along comes pine cone. Makes fun of stone. Won't leave him alone. Vanish, said Stick. His word does the trick. Stone whispers, "Gee, you stuck up for me." "That's just what sticks do. Friends do it too." Stick, Stone, no longer alone. Stick, Stone, a friendship has grown. They wander, explore. Lays by the shore. Then thunder and rain. Boom! A loud hurricane. Oh no. Look what's happening. Stick is windblown. There goes Pinecone. Hold on, calls out Stone. Again, he's alone. Search day. Stick, stick, stick! And search night. No stick in sight. What's this? A huge puddle? Stick stuck in the middle? Actually, it says stick stuck in the muddle of the huge puddle. Stone rescues him quick. There he goes. He's rolling down the hill. Hits the log. Cowabunga! Kersploosh! And look at what's happening to Stick. He's flying out of the puddle. You rock, Stone, says Stick. That's just what stones do. Best friendship rocks too. Stick, Stone, together again. Stick, Stone, a perfect 10 to the end. And look at Pineco says, sorry, I needled you so much. And that is Stick and Stone. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that story. I picked that one for the new year because I thought it's a perfect time for us to start fresh, try to include all of our friends, stick up for each other, be kind. It's a new year, which gives us a chance to start all over with kindness and being nice to one another. So I love this story, Stick and Stone, how they become friends and then they stick up for each other. And I hope we can do more of that this year. All right, Tigers, have a great day. And remember, it's a great day to be a Tiger.